I would like to share some research progress in my research group, focusing on the flame retardant nanomaterials. So I'm going to talk about some background first. As we know, the polymer-based materials were widely used in our daily life. So if we look around, you'll almost find the polymer used, the base material has been used everywhere. So, and another very interesting topic is the fire, because fire is one of the oldest technology. But in the recent years, unwanted fire are growing problems. It's a global problem because more flammable polymer material has been used. The fire risk also increased. So in the newspaper, in the televisions, we can always hear about these accidents related to the fire. So our understanding on the fire is still limited, but usually if the combustion of the polymeric materials happened, so there are several main stages. So the first part is the ignition part, and after this stage, the fire will go to the developing fire stage, and then it moves to the developed fire stage, and finally it goes to the flame out, now extinguished. So this is the basic steps for a fire. What we can do to reduce the loss in fire? So actually, by using the flame retardant is the very efficient way. So directly, a flame retardant can contribute to the saving of the leaks, because people have more time to escape in the fire conditions. But also the fire retardant have a lot of limitations. So for example, we might stop the fire, but generate a lot of smoke. So there are a lot of problems behind all of that. So in our understanding, the fire retardant basically divided into two main types. It's halogen-containing flame retardants and halogen-free flame retardants. But due to the environmental concerns, more and more research and also industrial products focus on the halogen-free flame retardant. There are big families in the halogen-free flame retardants. So today we will focus on the topic of nano-sized flame retardant. Compared to the halogen containing flame retardant, the halogen-free flame retardant is more environmental friendly relatively, but usually it has a low efficiency. So still there are a lot of challenges to develop halogen-free flame retardant. In 2019, in the international conference, my group proposed the current development stage of the nanomaterials as flame retardant. So basically, in our understanding, we are still in the young stage, earlier stages of this nano-sized flame retardant. So we work a lot in the last, I would say, nearly 10 years. Still, there are a lot of challenges in these research topics. So we just list several ones here. The first one is the interface. So how to solve the interface between the nanomaterials and the polymer matrix is still a key challenge. So in the past years, we worked quite a lot in these directions and try to improve the interaction between the fillers and also the polymer matrix. And the other important issue is the mechanisms. So this mechanism means once we got some properties in fire or in other mechanical properties, so we need to clearly know what's the mechanism behind that. So if we have very limited knowledge on it, it's hard to make further molecular design and to develop new materials. So, and also multifunction, how to realize the multifunction for the new nanomaterial to polymer is another important challenge. Nanomaterials as a flame retardant actually has a long history. So we can, if we went back to the literatures, so in the last 20 or even 30 years, there are a lot of publications. We just report some new progress in these lectures. We just give several examples like layer double hydroxide, carbon nanotubes, and metal organic frameworks, and also potentially advanced applications by using such flame retardant technology. Firstly, we can find very funny things in our daily life. For an extinguished candle, if we address a burner above these candles, it can be easily reburned, this candle. It means there are some relationship between the smoke and the burning. So how to understanding this behavior, that could be really important for other further designing. So that's why we did quite a lot of experimental and try to understand what happened behind of these phenomena. So based on this basic understanding, we designed these new nanomaterials. We used the layer double hydroxide as the host materials, and we used another bio-based materials, cyclodextrin, as the guest molecules. And also the ferrocene had been inserted into the cyclodextrin. And based on these combinations, we could achieve both of the high flame retardancy and low smoke production. So the mechanism behind that, based on our understanding, is the smoke produces at high temperature, it can be further degradable by this catalyst from the ferrocene in the gas phase. And in the condensed phase, more and more smoke precursors can be converted from the aliphatic phase to the aromatic structures. So in this case, they will reduce the release of the flammable stuff to the gas phase. That's why they can reduce the smoke release and also improve the flame retardancy. Another work is related to the functionalization of layer double hydroxide. So as we know, the LDH is the layer structures. Actually, in the gallery, there is a very interesting place. It can be replaced by a lot of guest molecules. So that's why if we can design the guest molecules in a good way, theoretically, we can realize the multifunction. So that's why by following these ideas, we designed different molecules. And these molecules can be inserted into the gallery of these nanostructures. And finally, we can reach different properties what we expected. Of course, one of the main targets for us is to improve the flame retardant efficiency. So by using this kind of functionalization, we can clearly see the fire retardants had been improved. For example, compared to the unmodified LDH-based epoxy with certain amount, without any functionalization, and the fire cannot extinguish, it keep burning until burning out. And by following this standard, we did the same test for functionalized LDH-based epoxy. And we can clearly see and the fire behavior are completely different. So in the first ignition for 10 seconds, this fire can be extinguished easily. And even we apply the second time burning, it also can extinguish easily. So if we look the IOI values, and UR94, this result also clearly shows us after this functionalization, the fire retardancy of the composite has been improved quite a lot. So then by following this work, we did a further study. So we introduced the interfacial catalysis effect into the nanomaterials. So we hope the different mechanism can work together. So by following this idea, we get big progress. So initially, we need 8% functionalized LDH to stop the fire, to realize extinguishment. But with the improvement of the efficiency, we can reduce this loading from 8% to 6% to 5% and even to 3%. And this means all of this composite can reach the same fire retardant level. They can pass the UR94V0. So that means the functionalization of aero dish is so important if we want to improve the flame retardant efficiency. So in order to further understand what happened or what's the difference between the different functionalized aero dish, and we did this further study, especially in the condensed phase, and we found after burning, the microstructure of the char are completely different. So if we use the normal nanomaterials-based composite, and we can clearly see the char residue is more brittle and weak, and also there are some gap between the residue from the nanoparticles and the char matrix. There are some gaps. But on the other hand, if we compare to the functionalized aerodige-based epoxy composite, and we can clearly see the char is much stronger and tougher, and there is no clearly gap between the residues from the particles and the char matrix. And this interesting phenomenon help us to propose a new mechanism. So for conventional nanomaterial-based polymer nanocomposite, if the fire happened, and the carbonization will happen as well. But the mechanism is mainly from up to the bottom. So if we consider the nanomaterials as a reference, but on the other hand, the functionalized nanomaterials, which interfacial catalysis effect, we can propose a two-way carbonization. It's not only from up to the bottom, and also from the bottom to the up. And this can help to improve the flame retardant efficiency due to the condensed phase mechanisms. So we know that if the fire happened, there are three key factors. And in this mechanisms, and we can clearly reduce the oxygen and heat transfer. That's why we can extinguish the fire. Another example is from the carbon nanotube. And the carbon nanotube has attracted a lot of attention in the past 30 years. But we found if we cut the samples, only shorten the CMT, we can get the different fire behavior. So it's very interesting phenomenon. So you can clearly see if we cut it from a certain launch to the shorter ones, with the same loading, and the ROI values show us difference. And if we use the different loadings of the carted CNT, and we also can find the oxygen the limited oxygen index improved. And this is we think is related to the free radical discouraging effect, but we need more evidence to prove that. So that's why we designed this new experimental. We use the tempo as the agent to react with this doubling bond on the CNT. So with this, we can we find a very interesting phenomenon. So compared to the untreated CNT, after using the tempo treating, the composite show much lower the ROI values. So the main reason is the tempo is also a radical scavenging agent. So if we use this tempo react with the carted CNT, both of them, the function to the radicals will become much lower because they react together. So that's why the final performance in the flame retardancy became much lower. So that's why this result prove this free radical scavenging mechanisms. And the next example is we would like to show something related to the MOF. MOF, the full name is the metal organic frameworks. So in fact, in other applications like gas separation or sensors, there are quite a lot of studies and applications. But the study in the flame retardant field is just appears in the recent years. So in this work, we use this kind of morph as the host materials. And after completely cleaning of this morph materials, so we can address the gas molecules, actually it's the flame retardant molecules, into the gallery of this morph. And after address it, and we found actually they can realize a very good performance compared to the reference samples. If we don't address these molecules into the morph, actually we cannot use it directly for the this unsaturated polyester. But after this fabrication, we can easily cure this unsaturated polymers. Not only that, we found the performance improved quite a lot. So based on the heat, the concalorimeter test, we can clearly see the after this functionalization, and the peak heat release rate has been reduced largely compared to others. So that means, so firstly, by using this strategy, so we can make the impossible to possible, and also we can improve the flame rate and efficiency greatly. Another example related to the morph is we can design the new morph or new functionalized morph. For example, in this work, we address three functions in one morph. So it means we can address the acid source, these gas sources and also carbon sources together in one morph structures, and then use it in the polymer matrix as a flame retardant. Another work is also related, is we use the morph as the starting material, and also based on the self-assembling, so we can introduce other stuff on the surface, and this stuff can provide the different function, for example, interfacial catalysis, in order to improve the flame retardancy of the polymers. So, and the main idea is to further understand what happened of the this char residues. So here we find a very interesting result. By using this kinds of combination of flame retardant, and we can get an alternating loose and accumulated char layer structures. And this is the first time to find these phenomena. So by using the X-ray tomography, and we can clearly see the different, the loose layers and the accumulated layers show different structures. And these are structures, and also we try to provide explanation what happened. In fact, if the intumescence behavior happened, so inside there are a lot of volatiles, and these volatiles want to move out. And during this movement, actually, they can force the char layers to the different directions. And finally, it formed these loose layers and also condensed layers. So other examples is related to multifunctional flame retardant based on nanomaterials. So here we just provide one example. So the nano cobalt hydroxide can be used as multifunctional agent to the thermal polyurethane, because after using it at very low loading, and it can reach good flame retardancy. For example, the peak heat release rate get a good reduction, and also total smoke production also decreased. So, but we can think about it. If this polymer-based material come to the end of the service life, so people need to think how to recycle such materials. So basically, for thermoplastic, we can reshape it and recycle it. But nevertheless, when it comes to the end of the service life, we need to think how to really utilize it. So we create this new strategy for it. And these materials, actually, in the heat conditions, it can be converted into the carbon nanotube directly. due to the strong catalysis effect from this cobalt hydroxide. And that's why we mentioned it can be a combination between the flame retardancy and the sustainability. So finally, I would like to say some advanced applications by using such technologies. One possible application is the for the battery. For example, we use this kind of MOF as a flame retardant and use it to develop a fully solid state but electrolyte and then fabricate the battery. And we found we can get a very good balance or even simultaneously improve both of the flame retardancy and electrochemical performance. For example, in this figure B, we can clearly see the heat release rate of the electrolyte has been reduced. And these findings help us to create more possibilities. So we could use it to develop the fire safe batteries and also based on the solid state electrolyte. And also the further applications can be used in the electronics and also the electrical car and a lot of applications. Another example we developed is the fire safety nano generator. So we can see this fire testing. We developed the different layers, for example, the negative layers and positive layers. So in general, this some layers is the high flammable. So we developed this flame retardant layers and then use it to fabricate the nano generators. So from the flame retardancy point of view, we can improve the flame retardancy greatly by using this flame retardant strategy. On the other hand, the electrical output also has been improved by using the flame retardant strategy. So both of them have been improved. So for example, when we use the hand pressing, we can power up to 38 LED lights. So that means this is the completely powered by the hand. So it could be used in future for the energy harvesting. Another example is we developed the self-powered thermal runaway sensors. And this could be really interesting to protect or monitoring the potential dangers of the battery, especially for the electrical car, or can be used for any other battery powered devices. So in these cases, we just address our thermal runaway sensor, and this is self-powered. We don't need to use additional power to light it or to work it, for it. So it can be completely self-powered. Theoretically, if the potential dangers happened from the battery, and it can deliver the signal to the driver, and especially on the dashboard of the car, you can see the one warning. Means, for example, if the battery 40 is dangerous, we need to stop the car. So this will bring more opportunities to the drivers to save the time or to escape the car compared to the current technology. The last example is recently we developed a fire-safe bio-based phase change materials. And this bio-based phase change materials could have quite large applications. So for example, it can be used as the packaging materials for batteries. So currently, the battery need to be transported from one place to another. And during this transportation, there are some potential dangers in the accidents. So with these packaging materials, maybe we can greatly reduce these risky things. And also can be used for making the multifunctional clothes and maybe to use it in the advanced 5G devices because it can adjust the temperature. Now the mobile phone, they release a lot of heat during working. So maybe by using these materials, we can reduce this, or we can balance this properties. And also could be possible to use the, in the refrigerated truck and smart building, and also maybe collect the waste heat storage. All this interesting work is not published yet, but we think the bio-based fire safety phase change materials will be important materials in the future. So finally, I would like to conclude something. Nanomaterials as flame retardant to polymers is a promising way, in our opinion. So, but molecular design to the nanomaterials is very important by considering both of the expected properties of polymers and also some fire hazards occurred in the polymer combustion. Multifunction and high effectiveness will be still the main directions at developing new nanomaterials. However, the depth of understanding of flame retardant mechanism is the crucial to carry out the above mentioned. So we really hope the people could take more attention on understanding the mechanism behind of the properties. So finally, I have to thank my group members for their dedications and efforts to all of this work, especially in the hard situation in Europe currently. And also I would like to thank the financial support from different agencies. Finally, thank you for listening. We are opening to keep any collaborations with any collaborators from all over the world. So if you are interested in any of them, please feel free to contact with me by following email. Thank you very much.